the Shiva Cement erstwhile mine. Put together now, both mines combined, JSW Cement and its subsidiary Shiva Cement has over 100 million tons of limestone available. And with that, it gives me great pleasure to announce that we will be commencing our project over there. We will be putting up a 1 million ton clinkerizing unit as well as a 1 million ton grinding unit at Shiva Cement. Work will commence in April of 2020, and it will be a 24-month project before this is commissioned. This is part of our wider plan of becoming a 25 million ton cement company by 2023. The idea is that the Shiva Cement will give us enough clinker that, and it will give us the clinker security for our grinding units in both Bengal and Odisha. Combined with that, we will be expanding in the west by adding capacity in our Dolvi unit. We will be getting its clinker from our Fujairah unit, which is going to be up and running in the next couple of months. And then we will also be expanding in the south, where our main focus, along with our PSC and Concrete HD and OPC, will be on our GGBS and on increasing our penetration through our GGBS, which is a performance enhancer in all concrete applications. So with that, our ambition is today JSW Cement is the ninth largest cement company in India. And by over the next 3 years, we would like to break into the top five bracket organically. And the company is also looking at various opportunities in the inorganic space. And that is not currently part of the 25 million ton plan. Any inorganic acquisition would be over and above the stated target of 25 million tons. So with that, I'd like to hand over to our CEO, Nilesh Narvekar, who will speak to you about some of the achievements of JSW Cement.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to touch on one point which is fairly significant, and we're fairly proud of it. It is about JSW Cement PEC having the lowest global warming potential in the cement industry. And it's not something we claim, we certified by EPD, which is an environment product declaration firm, a Swedish firm. And what it does is it basically independently verifies the global warming potential by appointing an independent agency which assesses this. In this case, it was done by ThinkSteps, which is a German agency. In terms of some of your interest in the statistics on this, around all of us know the carbon dioxide that cement industry emits. So in terms of what our Portland slag cement does, it is around 325 kgs per ton of cement, as against normally if it's PSC, OPC, sorry, it's close to 800 tons of CO2 per ton of cement. And as against that, if you look at PPC, it's close to anywhere between 550 and 650 kgs of CO2 per ton of cement. So that is one thing which we're very, very proud of, and that's going to be a mainstay. We are responsible, we are conscious, and we believe this is the way forward for us. I'll hand it over to Swami to speak about
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to talk about, you know, why we are announcing this expansion, when particularly when we are seeing that economic slowdown and there is a slowdown in all the other industries, what we are hearing in the news. If you look into cement industry as such, you know, the growth story is very much intact in the cement industry. We are right now having a capacity as an industry of 496 million tons. As against that, our consumption is 335 million tons, over 7.72% capacity utilization in the FY19. And you know, if you look into the per capita consumption of the India, is around 200 to 250 kilogram per person, as compared to all India or all over the world average of 500 plus. Plus, even if you look into the population, it was around 120 crores in FY12, and it has risen to 135 crores in FY19. If you look into all the other indicators, and even if you look into the last 5 years of growth, cement industry has shown a CAGR growth of 8.2%, and whereas the capacity growth was only 4.5%. And which increases the capacity utilization from 63% to 70% in the last 5 years. And the markets in which we operate, what we observe, that particularly in the East, the growth has been in the last 5 years to the extent of 18 to 20%. There was around 90 million tons of capacity, whereas the demand is 80 million tons already. Although there are a lot of capacity addition, but the demand growth for the housing sector in the East is remarkable as compared to other zones of the country. East has been growing phenomenally in the last 5 years. And in the current year, it is a little muted. We expect the year to end with a muted growth. And we expect that in the next two quarters, we are seeing signs of revival in the current quarter. And in the next, after next two quarters, we expect the demand to revive back to 10 to 20% growth in the East. And in the West, if you look into it, we are very strategically positioned in Dolvi. And we have a lot of projects which are coming in Bombay, Navi Mumbai Airport, Metro Rail, and so on and so forth, which is itself is going to consume around 7.5 million tons. And we are better positioned to, take this opportunity for the expanded growth in the Western region. Western region, as on date, is having around 72 million tons of capacity and 63 million tons of demand. Still, there is a scope for further growth in the West. So we feel that we are strategically located for the expansion and take the expanded project as an opportunity. In South, although it is there is a capacity overhang, that is 170 million tons of cement capacity, whereas the demand is only to the extent of 70 million tons. But we are very well positioned to expand our capacity, because the OPC, which is the ordinary Portland cement, which is mainly used for the infrastructure, which is the OPC consumption out of 70 million tons is 30 million tons, out of which we are supplying GGBS, which is right now we are consuming around 2.5 million tons in South. We have a big opportunity to grow in GGBS as well as in slag. Slag right now we are having only 3% of the market, where we have an opportunity to the growth. So that is why we are expanding, and all our expansions are going to fructify only in FY21 and FY22. So by that time, the demand, you will see that the demand has come back to normal, and we will be in a better position to take the opportunity of the growth in demand in India. So I will ask Narendra.